Hey everyone, I was recording this, but I suddenly just really got sick. So I just wanted to say that my voice will probably sound a bit sickish, so please cut me some slack. The Italian M1139 was bad, and I'll explain why over the course of this video. In 1936, the Italian army issued requirements for a tank with a 3-man crew and a 37mm L40 gun mounted, and two 8mm machine guns. But the need for a medium tank led FIAT to make a new hull for 1938. But they didn't have a strong enough turret to support the 37mm main armament, so they decided to use the hull to mount the main armament, and the turret to mount the machine guns. It was normal for the time, the M1139 took inspirations from other designs, for example the Vickers 6. The M1139's name was a combination of several things. The M stood for medium, the 11 for its weight, so it was 11 tons heavy. At first they actually wanted to make it 10 tons heavy, but they went slightly over it. And it was expected to enter service in 1939, so they added the 39. The M1139 was outfitted with a 105 horsepower V6 diesel engine, which allowed the tank to go roughly 32 kilometers an hour. The tank did have some issues with reliability, and this was amplified by the fine desert dust. As a result of this, a lot of M1139s were eventually abandoned. The tank was presented to the leader of Italy in October 1938, which did do include a radio. However, this one was the only one of the 100 vehicles which was outfitted with a radio. So the crews were forced to rely on flag signals to communicate with each other. A small little fun fact is that Pirelli was the rubber supplier for these tanks' wheels. The same company today is the tyre supplier of elite racing series like Formula 1. The M1139 was relatively small. It was only about 2.2 meters wide, 2.3 meters tall and 4.7 meters long. And like I said before, the tank only had 3 crew members. So the 3 crew members were the commander, the gunner and the driver. The commander sat in the small turret with the 2 machine guns, the gunner sat at the main armament, and the driver was in the front left of the tank. An issue the commander faced was that he could not stand upright in the tank itself, and he could also be hit by the recoil of the gun. While the gunner was also in a very tight position and was risked being hit by the revolving turret mechanism. So as you can imagine, you wouldn't want to be a tank crewman on this vehicle. The M1139 was a light armored vehicle for its time when you compare it to the heavyweights, which it shared the battlefield with, for example the Matilda 2 and Char B1 bis heavy tanks, but it did the job. However, the issue is that for the main armament to be relatively effective against the Allies, it had to be within at least 900 meters of its target, and at that distance it is itself vulnerable to all types of enemy fire. The anti-tank gun in 1940 used by the British was mainly the 2-pounder anti-tank gun. This gun had a penetration power of 34 millimeters on the 30 degree angled armor at a range of 900 meters, while at most the M1139 had armor thickness of 30 millimeters of armor. Also an interesting fact is that the Italians most of the time used the bolted armor plates on their tanks, and the M1139 was no exception. A downside of this is that some bolts are placed on the inside of the tank, and when the tank is hit with enough force, the bolts can detach and spall, killing the crew. The reason they still chose to use bolting was because it was extremely cheap and simple. At the time, welding steel was the perfect method, while casting, which is much higher in strength and quality, was still too expensive and time consuming to be practical. The main armament the Italians used was classified by the British as outdated. They referred to it as Spezia 1918. However, despite its older background, it was light and compact, weighing only 95 kilograms. Ammunition for this main armament is held in boxes below the gun, and the total storage was around 84 rounds. Now we come to everyone's favorite part, service history, North Africa. 24 of the M1139s were sent to East Africa and the rest was sent to Libya, and these tanks formed the 1st and 2nd medium tank battalions. The first time these tanks actually saw combat was at the Battle of Sidi Azeiz, where they knocked out 2 tanks and captured 2, but lost 3 M1139s in the process. Later in that year they were encircled, to be more precise it was in November 1940. Some of the M11s were lost due to attempt at breaking free of the encirclement, and as a result they lost 5 of their 27 operational M11s. Some of these tanks were also captured by the Australians. They quickly painted a white kangaroo on them to signal to other tanks that this was a captured Axis tank. They also made 3 companies with it, which were named Dingo, Wombat and Rabbit. Many of these M11 39s were also broken, damaged, or immobilized inside some strategic Italian positions. The British used their Matilda heavy tanks to overrun many of the Italian positions, and the M11 could not do a little thing about the heavy armor of the Matildas. Like I stated before, mechanical failures were a continuous issue. For example, deploying 39 M11 39 tanks to the front of Tobruk entailed a 60 km road march for the tanks under their own power. This is because there weren't a lot of transport trucks or specifically designed trailers for this. As a result, only 5 of them got there in working order. By January 1941, only 5 M11 39s were left operational in North Africa for the Italian forces, and these were lost at El Adem on the 21st of January. East Africa. There were 24 M11 39s sent to East Africa, so of course they made two companies. These were named the 321st and the 322nd, both containing 12 tanks. They participated in taking Kassala and Sudan, and the 322nd took part in taking British Somaliland, and a unit was destroyed by the combined efforts of the British and South African forces. One M11 39 was used by the South Africans. The 321st fought at Algordat and lost all of its units during this. So basically, the only M11 39s used on the African continent were captured vehicles. My opinion. Keep in mind, this is just my opinion. You can disagree with me and feel free to do so. Challenge my thoughts, it is allowed and welcome, just be respectful about it. So first off, I'd like to say that the M11 39 was an improvement when you look at the L3 33 and the L3 35. It was actually able to tangle with some of the British tanks, at least to some degree. However, it did not have an answer to better British vehicles. Well, for starters, one downside was that it wasn't very reliable. Like I stated before, the fine desert dust didn't help, but just in general, the tank wasn't reliable enough. It did not even have a radio. Even the French tanks had a radio, so communicating is very difficult in these tanks, harder than it should be at least. It wasn't very well armored, especially not for 1940-1941 standards. 30mm isn't a lot even for those times. It only really protected you against small arms, and the main armament was placed very awkwardly. Normally you don't want to have the main armament fitted in the hull because it limits your movement, but it also made it very uncomfortable and dangerous for the commander, and also the gunner, of course. The main armament wasn't very strong either, so it was basically helpless against tanks like the Matilda 2. This is also a part of the reason why I really like the Matilda 2. It is one of my favorite tanks. However, I do want to give the M11 39 some credit for being a substantial upgrade compared to the previous tanks fielded by Italy. Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, this was the video for today. Like I said before, I was pretty sick during the recordings of this video, but I had to get this video out today, so I just had to do it. I hope you guys enjoyed it nonetheless. I will see you guys in the next video, and yeah, bye.